All right, expected in just a couple of hours from now, unemployment stats for both Canada and the U.S. So a big day for economy watchers this morning. Here's Mike Eppel.
Yeah, good morning, Kevin. Probably the biggest day of the month that we await for signs about how the North American economy is doing. And it's one of those times when it's a double dose of jobs data for both Canada and the U.S. Stats Canada reports at 8:30 this morning about July jobs creation. You know, it's been a very choppy year so far for the Canadian labor market. We've got, you know, 1 month we're down a lot, and the next month we create some jobs. Well, July was supposed to be pretty good. Sort of a rebound from maybe still the fallout from the Fort McMurray wildfires and what that did to the oil sector. And the spillover effect into the labor market. 10,000 jobs forecast, 6.9% on the unemployment rate. It'll basically just be another sign of the economy is just doing a mediocre performance at this point. We've also got out of the States today, 175,000 jobs, maybe for July. June was certainly a strong month, almost 300,000 jobs there. In the States, the unemployment rate, 4.8%, which would be historically low, which sort of flies in the face of the unemployment or the economy itself, which is only growing at 1.2%. The naysayers would say, well, you know what, the U.S. is creating jobs, but they're all low-paying. There's a lot of Americans still on the outside looking in. So again, it'll all filter into economic and interest rate policy. And this morning, we're still seeing a carryover effect to what the Bank of England did yesterday, cutting its benchmark interest rate to a record low of 0.25%, and Mark Carney saying it could go to zero in the fallout of Brexit and what that means to the British economy and, by extension, the Eurozone. This morning, we're watching markets overseas climb, and bond yields took a big tumble yesterday, which could lead to even lower interest rates going forward. Speaking of interest rates and the effect that's having on the Toronto housing market, those numbers in from Toronto Real Estate Board for July, eye-popping, almost 10,000 home sales last month, a record-breaking July for overall sales, even though the number of new listings dropped again, which just leads to higher prices. More demand than there is supply, prices go up, and then the talk over the next couple of months, will we see the filter effect of the foreign buyers tax in BC coming, moving money into the Toronto real estate market, something to watch. The average price for a detached home now in the 416, $1.2 million, up 20% year over year. Interesting comments yesterday, Kevin, from the CEO of Tim Hortons, Restaurant Brands International, Daniel Schwartz, saying they could see there's no limit to how far the Tim's brand can travel. They're talking about taking that global. They're already going into the Philippines and other markets in the Middle East. So regardless of where you travel, you could get a double-double and a box of Timbits globally at some point in the future. And Nike's decision to exit the golf business, that was a bit of a shock to the market yesterday. Nike shares down. Not going to make golf clubs anymore, but Callaway, one of the big competitors, saw its stock price jump by 5%. And of course, the golf part of the Olympics and the spotlight on that for the next couple of weeks. Have a good weekend. Back to you.
You have a wonderful weekend as well. Thank you, sir.